Share. Skateboarding's hard. I want to marry King Henry VIII and then have my head chopped off and then be in a musical about it.
I feel like, you know in Mean Girls when she's like, you can think that you like someone but you could be wrong. That's how I feel right now. Because I was wrong and I am here to admit my faults to you, my lovely people. I was wrong about some musicals. I am a person who like, I make quite snap assumptions and snap opinions on things, which can be really good in some ways because I think I trust my instincts in a lot of ways, but in some ways it can be really bad because I'm just too plain old stubborn. These are all musicals that I thought that I wouldn't like, that then I went to go and see them and I loved them. And I just want to talk about them, and I want to talk about how wrong you can be about things. Maybe if you have similar like initial thoughts that I had, then maybe you would feel differently as well. So yeah, let's talk about it. We're gonna jump right into it because this is the reason why I wanted to make this video. Like 2 weeks ago, I went to go and see Fiddler on the Roof. The wonderful people at Official London Theatre sent me, and I was very, very grateful because I'd never seen the show before. I'd seen little snippets of it and I'd seen bits of the film, but never the whole thing in its entirety. I've listened to some of the songs. They're those songs that you kind of hear a million times, but you don't really know. It had just been on at the Menier Chocolate Factory and I'd heard amazing things about it. I heard it was an incredible production. So I thought, I really want to see it because I love Andy Nyman, who is playing Tevye. I saw him in Assassins at the Menier as well, one of my all-time favourite productions. He was in my all-time favourite role, which is Charles Guiteau. He sang the Ballad of Guiteau incredibly. So I knew I really, really wanted to see the production. And I thought it was going to be a great production, but I didn't think I was going to enjoy it in a weird way. I didn't think I would kind of like the musical. I just didn't think it was for me. So as you say, Official London Theatre, who are an incredible company. They do so much for London Theatre. They run the Olivier Awards. They're just amazing people. So they invited me and I was like, yeah, this is going to be fantastic. So excited. So it was at the Playhouse Theatre in London and I sat in the stalls. They'd taken out some of the first front rows of the stalls and the stage kind of like went through the audience, and then there was like a walkway and it was so cool and you felt very involved in the piece. And then it started and Andy Nyman came on and he starts doing this opening speech into the song Tradition, where he's talking about lots of kind of religious beliefs and things. And I thought, I don't know if this is going to be too religious for me. I don't want to offend anyone, but I'm not super religious. I went to Catholic school growing up. I'm from a Christian family. I don't have huge religious beliefs, and sometimes it can be a bit much for me because I feel a bit kind of out of my depth. So I thought, I'm not sure if this is going to be for me. I adored it. The production was absolutely incredible. It was beautiful. Everyone in the company was incredible. They had the most amazing voices and the storytelling. I think that's the thing that really sold me on the show. It was definitely the storytelling and I felt so many emotions. I don't remember the last time I went to the theatre and was so up and down with how I was feeling of like following the story and the different characters and the journeys that they go on. It's quite rare that I go to the theatre now and I see a show that I don't know super duper well. So to do that, and with such a traditional show as well and such a classic show, it was really kind of uplifting. And I go and see so many contemporary musical theatre productions, and I love contemporary musicals. I can admit that sometimes I don't kind of pay attention to the older shows, and I love that this production is currently on in the West End. You have to go and see it if you get a chance. It is beautiful. I think anyone who has emotions in their soul would love it. There's just so many, like, so many twists and turns, and you feel so deeply for the people and for their religion and for their lives and tradition. I just loved it. I thought it was amazing. I so regretted my initial thoughts of, oh, I'm not sure if I'm gonna like this. You can't always judge a book by what other people have told you about it. Oh, some of my friends got angry with me about this. Six. I'll be honest, people have said to me for so long, Amy, you have to see Six. And I'd seen the costumes and I was like, wow, those girls look banging. They look amazing. I love the way that they look and I love like kind of the hype around it. But I think that I kind of like missed the hype and I saw them at West End Live last year. In all fairness to them, they'd had a morning of rehearsal and then they went and performed at West End Live. So it was like insane that they even did that. But I didn't get this instant like,
love for it. I don't know why, I just didn't. And then I kind of like wasn't fussed about seeing it. At my birthday party, late on in the night, somebody was like, we should sing along to musicals. And I was like, I'm there for it. And somebody put on Six and everyone was singing along to it. And I thought, I don't like this. It sounded so contemporary to me. Hamilton is doing history in a contemporary way, but the way that Six does it is completely different. On the recording, I kind of didn't get that, if that makes sense. It was too much for me. Like, the way they're like, don't be bitter, cause I'm fitter. And I was like, is that a bit cringe? I'm just telling you how I feel. But so many of my friends were like, Amy, you have to see Six. I don't want to waste my time and my money going to see something if I'm not going to like it. So I just didn't give it a chance. And then Olivia had some tickets and she was like, Amy, come along. I went along and I sat down and I really liked the atmosphere before the show. The theatre, they all have like cocktails that are named after the six queens. They had like a photo wall of like fan art and I love like fan interactions with shows. And then you went and sat in the theatre and there's like pop songs being played on like a harpsichord and you're like, I feel like I'm in court. I love it. And then the show began and I truly ate all my words in the first like second. It opens and you feel like you're at the O2 because it's playing at the Arts Theatre in London, which is quite a small venue actually. It's like only a few hundred seater. It started and you're like, holy moly, am I seeing Ariana Grande right now? Am I seeing Little Mix? I'm not a huge pop fan, but I was fully sold within like 2 seconds of it starting. And they all look incredible and their voices are insane and there's it's so funny and it's so smart. And for example, like the song House of Holbein, I listened to the album. Well, I tried to, and I got to House of Holbein and I was like, nope, I'm switching this off, I don't like it. And in the show I'm like, absolutely yes, I was there for it. I thought it was amazing. Honestly, I'm a full Six stan now. I can't wait to see it again. Everyone I've spoken to, I've been like, you have to see Six. I'm trying to get a big group of girls for us to all go together because when I came out, I felt like such a sassy lady. And I was like, yes, I want to marry King Henry VIII and then have my head chopped off and then be in a musical about it. You know, honestly, it's great. You have to go and see it. Yeah. Okay, the next show that I need to talk about was The Cher Show. I love The Cher Show so much. If you followed my channel for a while, you know I love The Cher Show. I love it. I talk about it daily. I feel like that show really changed me as a person. It really inspired me. I could do a whole video on it. Would you like a video on The Cher Show? Let me know, because I would definitely be into that. But I want to talk specifically about the opinion I had beforehand and then actually going to see the show. I love Stephanie J. Block. She's a huge inspiration to me. I remember the very first time I ever heard her sing was singing, she told me about Captain Hook and all of his men who followed Peter with a hook replaced as his hand. I heard her singing on Scott Allen's album and I was like, I'm in love with this woman. She's been in everything, hasn't she? She was in 9 to 5, Falsettos, The Pirate Queen. I was gutted that I never got to see her in Falsettos. I was just gutted that I'd never seen her in anything before. And when I was going to New York in January, I was saying, oh, I don't know what to see for one of my shows. And my friend at work, Sarah, said to me, oh my God, Stephanie J. Block is in The Cher Show. You have to go and see The Cher Show. And I was like, I do not want to go and see Stephanie J. Block for the first time dressed up as Cher. No, that's not what I'm there for, you know? I was kind of against it. I'd seen Cher in Burlesque, and I love Burlesque, but I wasn't a huge Cher fan. I find it really hard to say the word Cher, by the way, so please know how hard this is. I don't know, I really struggle with the sh sound. Cher. Cher. The Cher Show. I find it really hard, anyway. What I can now say is I'm a Cher convert, and if I could turn back time, I would, because I regret everything I said. Such a loser. When we then were in New York, we were like, do you know what? I actually think I want to see The Cher Show because I just couldn't get over Stephanie J. Block being in the show. So we ended up going to see it and all day we just kept laughing about it. We were like, I cannot believe that the first time we're all going to see Stephanie J. Block, our queen, she's going to be dressed up as Cher. I kind of like couldn't get over it and I thought it was going to be like a bit of a joke. I could not have been more wrong. I remember when it opened and me and Olivia were sat next to each other and we looked across and we were like, This is iconic. It's one of the best things I've ever seen. It's so high up there in my Broadway list of favorite shows. I adore it. The three shares are incredible. I also feel sick that I met Teal Wicks at stage door and didn't talk to her about Finding Neverland because I was so shook about how much I loved the Cher show that I didn't even realize that she was Mrs. Barry in Finding Neverland. Dead. Honestly, it's like the best thing ever. The cast album came out yesterday and I'm obsessed with it. And people keep talking to me about going to New York and I'm like, but are you seeing the Cher show? And people are like, I'm going to New York, not sure what to see. The Cher show. You have to see the Cher show if you're in New York. If anyone talks to me and says that they didn't enjoy it, you're dead to me, bitch. Honestly, I came out the goddess warrior that I am today. I loved the Cher show. I love the Cher show. And I love saying the Cher show, even though I struggle so hard with it. Anyway, the Cher show. And then my final show. People on the internet were angry with me about this one. So I did a video called Reacting to SpongeBob the Musical. In it, I was like, I just don't think it's for me. I don't like it. And like Ethan Slater, who plays SpongeBob, I thought, I don't like his voice. I don't like his SpongeBob voice. I don't like cartoons. I don't like overly hyper stuff. I don't like things that's aimed at children. And then I went to see it. So I saw SpongeBob in the summer of 2018. And it was one of those ones, like, I went to go and see it. To be honest, this just shows what a childish, pathetic woman I am. I went to see it to prove people wrong because people were like, oh, Amy, you're gonna go to New York and you're just gonna go and see Mean Girls 10 times. Which, I mean, I've seen it 3 times now, so I'm well on my way. But I did go and see SpongeBob because I was like, I wanna show people that I'll give any show a chance. Which this video looks like it's not true that I don't give shows a chance, but I do try to anyway. I went to go and see SpongeBob and I thought I probably won't like it. There is a running theme here. And then I went into the theater and I literally gasped. So I was sat in the orchestra again, like down by the front in the stalls area, like right down the front. The doors opened and I literally was like, it was beautiful. I mean, the set was incredible. Incredible. Like, there was just so much to see and there was such an atmosphere. I really love an atmosphere before a show. It like really helps me like get in the mood. I was sat right down by the front by like, there was like a little sea shanty band and they're like playing little ukuleles, someone playing a kazoo, and I was just like, I feel like I am under the sea. The show blew my mind. I actually loved it. I was miserable for a lot of that week because I was tired and I was warm. Just very stressed the whole trip. That was one of my favorite moments of the trip. Going to see SpongeBob, I was completely hooked from the minute it began. Was really concerned about the music that, because it was written by all different people, like every song is written by different people, but the orchestration really pulled it together and there was like a real cohesiveness through the show, which I was really like concerned about before I saw it. Ethan Slater is one of the most incredible performers I have ever seen. Truly, he was amazing. And his stamina, both vocal and physical stamina, blew my tiny mind. He was a fantastic. The whole show, I loved it. Right, there was a moment where somebody had a skateboard, right? And you're like, skateboarding's hard. Well done, sir, for doing that on stage. But no, he didn't just have a skateboard. He had a skateboard and then he put another skateboard on top of that skateboard and you're like, wow, 2 skateboards, kudos to you. No. He had a skateboard and then a skateboard and then he did a handstand on the skateboards. And then was skateboarding in a handstand with like out of harness. I was dead. I couldn't cope. The vocals in the show were incredible. The visuals, oh my God, the set was insane. The choreography was so good. And Ethan Slater, I can't talk enough about Ethan Slater. He does this backbend thing in the show and you're like, how are you not broken from doing that? I mean, we all know I love Wesley Taylor because I am the number one smash stan. But seeing Wesley Taylor in a show really was like a huge moment for me as well. It was a bit like a Stephanie J Block moment. I was like, I can't believe I'm gonna get to see Wesley Taylor in a show because I just admire him so much. And so that was really special. And it was just a great show and I well and truly have eaten all my words and it was the best day ever. I'm such a loser. Anyway, that was my video. I hope that you enjoyed it. Thank you so much for watching. I want to know what shows you thought that you wouldn't like and then you did like them. I also want to know what shows you just think that you won't like so you're not gonna see them, because I want to see if I've seen them and if I can convince you to see them, or if seeing this video will maybe change your mind and show you that sometimes you might like something that you think you won't. Thanks so much for watching. I will see you next time. I love you lots. Bye.